Hi, and welcome to this installment of Frank and Mary on Martha's Vineyard. If you haven't seen the show before, my name is Art Bergeron. I'm an elder law attorney. I come to the island and do presentations at the Sister Bree Senior Center. I had started this show thinking that it was a show about law, but it really isn't, which is why we changed the name of the show to not be my name, but Frank and Mary. If you've been to any of my presentations, you know Frank and Mary and their kids, Peter, Paul, and Mary Jr. And you know their goal is to live in their house until they die and be buried in the backyard. And that really means being able to stay in their neighborhood and in their community, no matter what. Now, for you to do that, there are some people that you need to know if you're a senior, right? Or if you've got parents that are seniors and you're kind of taking care of them. And that's why you should be watching this show with my co-host, Sandy Cordobi, whom many of you have met from Horizons Geriatric, born and raised here, the geriatric care manager here on the island. And so Sandy is going to introduce our guest, whom you really need to know, and you need to know about her business and what she does, her business, I shouldn't, about the entity that she works for. Sandy.
Hi.
How's that?
I guess I should correct, just so that we don't cause any controversy. I unfortunately was not born here. Can you imagine?
Come on.
My mother was, but I wasn't. Anyway, my children were.
I never knew this.
Thank you, Arthur.
The things that come out. The things that come out on this show.
I'm honored to be considered.
So anyway, that said,
I am delighted and honored to introduce our guest to our viewers today, Megan Panek, who is born and bred here and will introduce herself very shortly. Megan is the director of the Martha's Vineyard area of Elder Services of Cape Cod and the Islands, and my go-to girl for everything. When it comes to elder care on Martha's Vineyard, she is my first stop, or my start with all of my clients. So I couldn't do what I do without Megan and her crew. Right. And she's such an amazing person and does so much for the elders on the island.
That
you just had to meet her. So Megan,
thank you.
Tell us a little bit. Well, first of all, who are you? And sort of, you know, what's your story here?
Yeah, what is your story?
As a community person.
Why are you still here? Why are you still here?
So I was born and raised on this island.
Yeah.
I've lived here pretty much my whole life. I went to college at Bridgewater State University.
Yeah.
I got my bachelor's degree in psychology.
Ooh.
And I just have such a passion and love for this island and community. And definitely knew that I wanted to stay here. I always say you have to leave somewhere in order to really understand how much you love and really want to stay there.
I have a paralegal, Brenda Costa, who's just
this.
Yes.
Yeah.
So, and did you come back right back from college? Did you come
I did.
Right back
I did. I knew. Yeah. I knew this was the place I wanted to be immediately when I went to school.
I missed it like no other. Bridgewater? You didn't want to live in like Bridgewater?
Bridgewater is actually up and coming. It's becoming, it's nice. It's a nice area. I lived there for 4 years, so the whole time. A lot of people actually commute from the island to Bridgewater.
That's true.
So I decided to,
No, I didn't know that.
So I decided to stay and,
I'm from Taunton.
Yeah, so you know
right
the area.
Now, yes.
Yep, I used to go to Taunton all the time.
So you came back, and when you came back, what did you start off by doing when you came back here?
So I came back to the island, and I immediately started applying for positions that were in my field or related to my field, and I ended up actually getting the care manager position for Elder Services of Cape Cod and the Islands. So that's good. That's where I started.
So, so you've been there the whole time?
Yes.
That's right.
I was a care manager for 5 years, and that was great because I really got used to the community and got to meet all the different community organizations and Sandy and all the different players. And so that was really good and helped to hone all the resources that I had. And I was in that position for about 5 years. And then the director position came available. And I've been there for over a year
and
now.
And that was
She's
Jackie
so
Cage.
Young. She's
I know.
So young.
I know.
Oh my God.
That was Jackie
and
Cage,
Jackie.
Who we all knew and loved and sort of was the guru of elder services on Martha's Vineyard forever. And and you worked, she trained you.
Yes.
And sort of broke you in and
Exactly.
And so Elder Services of Cape Cod and the Islands. What in the world is that? Right? Because once again, I talk to folks,
what is
you know,
that?
And they'll say, because as we were talking before the show, one of the hardest parts about being a senior is if you're trying to plan because you may need services later or because you really do need them.
Right.
There's all these different things in this private sector and public sector, and what do I do?
Exactly.
You know, there's the senior center. So kind of can you just talk about Elder Services of Cape Cod and a little bit of background? You know, kind of what is it?
Absolutely.
I hear this term aging services access point, ASAPS.
Right.
What are those things?
Exactly. So Elder Services of Cape Cod and the Islands, we started in 1972. We're a nonprofit organization. We do answer to the state. We're the state-appointed agency, so the Executive Office of Elder Affairs. That's who runs us and oversees us.
So you're a nonprofit and you contract with the state?
Right. Yes. Okay. Yep, and we just provide an array of different programs and services dedicated to the changing needs of the older adult. So we usually start everyone off with our information and referral department. That's our main office in South Dennis.
Yeah. By the way, once again, we were talking earlier, and the earliest program that you guys did was
Meals on Wheels.
Our
nutrition program.
If you ever people ever wondered where Meals on Wheels came, it really comes from someplace, and it's you guys.
Yes. Yeah, it does. Yeah.
Absolutely. Yes, our nutrition program and our Meals on Wheels program is big here now. Yeah. It's always growing. We deliver Monday through Friday. We have an array of different volunteers to deliver the meals, so that's great. Yeah. Our volunteers are really appreciated, and they do an awesome job. So
and they've got their eyes on. So many times I get a call from one of the volunteers that delivers to Mary Smith every day and knows if Mary looks a little different today. So it's more than just dropping off a meal, isn't it?
It's a wellness check as well. Yes. So they will check in on them and make sure they're okay and have, you know, a few minute conversation with them as well as delivering them the meal, which is their one meal that they get a day. That's a nice balanced meal, and they really appreciate that. So
it's important.
And the meals that happen at the senior centers are also, they're a part of Meals on Wheels.
Yes, that's our senior dining program. So
senior dining program.
Yep, we offer it at the Oak Bluffs Council on Aging, the Up Island Council on Aging, and the Tisbury Council on Aging. Tisbury is Monday through Friday, Oak Bluffs is Tuesday and Thursday, and Up Island is Thursdays.
And so who can go to that?
Anyone 60 and older.
No matter which town, right?
Yes, exactly. Yep, no matter which town. They just can't have a life-threatening food allergy. That's the only stipulation with the program. Yeah. We just can't deal with cross-contamination. Our Meals on Wheels program, as well as our senior dining program, all come out of the hospital. So the Martha's Vineyard Hospital makes the meals, and then we deliver them from there.
So that's
pretty terrific. Mm-hmm. So I didn't mean to divert you.
But I think that's a really important resource for our elders to know about is that these meals.
Yeah.
Do you have to call in advance and make a reservation?
So for the Meals on Wheels program, it's a little bit different. All of our programs have to be referred through our central intake information and referral office in South Dennis. So they would call the main office number, which is 1-800-244-4630, and they would make a referral for any of our programs. And if they're unsure of which program, that's where the INR specialist comes in, and they can explain each of the programs and help them figure out which one to refer to. So it's a great central resource.
And by the way, we'll ask Carl, our wonderful producer, to do a banner that's got that phone number, so that for folks who are watching this show, if they just want to write it down,
then they'll kind of know.
Great, thank you.
So can you just talk about that? So you mean someone has to actually call outside of this island in order to?
Yes, and
yes,
I know. It's a little it can be a little overwhelming, but just to reassure you, the referrals do go into that one number, but then they are referred back to us on the Vineyard. So our Martha's Vineyard office is just in the Martha's Vineyard Hospital, so the referral will come back to us. One of our two, depending on which program they go to, we do have a care manager for our nutrition program. So she would go out to see you if you were going to sign up for the Meals on Wheels. And then we do have two, and then we do have two full-time home care managers that if you want to get in-home home care services, you would get the referral, they would get the referral and go out and see them.
Mm-hmm. That's pretty terrific.
It's that Meals on Wheels is often a springboard to your full array of services, right?
Mm-hmm. It's a good starting point,
Because I always tell clients, I say, you want to sign up with Elder Services even if you don't need anything. Or even if you don't think you need anything, just call them and find out what they do.
Exactly.
Because it may be that they got something that you really would like.
And like I said, we have an array of different programs, so just calling that number and speaking to an INR specialist, and they can give you all the info for the different programs.
So can you just kind of talk about some of those? Because I know that beforehand you were like, I'm never going to fit all this in. There's so many programs.
There is a ton of programs.
You talked about the meal and by the way, is there another piece of the nutrition program? Is there any nutrition training? Is there any of that stuff that they also offer? And then can you talk about home care and stuff a little bit?
Yeah, so the nutrition program we just basically talked, it's the senior dining and the Meals on Wheels. Those are the two major parts of it. Like I said, the different COAs is where we offer the senior dining program. So if you, you know, need to get out for socialization and you want to drive over there, that's another way to get a meal, as well as the Meals on Wheels, which is the home delivery. Yeah. So
COA is Council on Aging.
Yes,
and Council on Aging. Like Tisbury Council on Aging and the Anchors in Edgartown,
right,
and the Oak Bluffs,
mm-hmm,
and then what's the one in West Tisbury called?
Up Island Council on Aging.
Up Island, mm-hmm, Council on Aging at the, yes, House. Yeah, yeah.
Right, yep, yep, exactly.
I never knew that. There's a name, the House.
The House. Yeah, like,
yes,
the Anchors
house.
Is the Edgartown, yeah, one,
yeah,
and yeah.
Yep.
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, and the home care program is a little more extensive. We do offer all of our in-home services. We can also offer Meals on Wheels as part of the program. We have our care managers go out and do what's called an intake assessment. They, yeah, come up with a service plan of what they think they're needing for services.
So you don't have to go to Dennis.
No,
you don't even have to go to the Edgartown, to the hospital, to the hospital.
In fact, once you do the referral, then you wait to get a phone call from one of our care managers,
yeah,
and that's when they'll ask you a little bit about, you know, what services they're looking for. They'll schedule to go out and do the intake assessment with you, and they'll come right to your home. They sit there and they go through a different assessment on your needs, and then they would determine what services are needed, and they would implement the service plan, and then they would see them ongoing to make sure all the services are going well. Obviously, you know, for our different programs, we see people every 6 months, and then if they're on a specialty program, which I can get into, they would be seen every 3 months. So that's where the visits come with our care managers, and obviously they're always available for a phone call if there's any questions as well.
And I suppose that's where you must be just constantly, when you're talking to folks, just saying,
yes,
yeah, just call.
We talk to Sandy a lot.
The first
too.
Question I ask my new clients is, have you met Megan at Elder Services? Because you need to know Megan at Elder Services.
So when you're talking about can you just talk about those two packages first? What are the parts of that package?
So to start off, for the home care program, in order to be able to qualify for that program, you do have to have what's called a critical need.
Yeah.
So it's meal prep, shopping, personal care, or med management. One of those needs does have to be met in order to open up for the home care program.
I see.
And then we do take a look at your finances. We just ask for an estimate of your income. From there, we would determine, we have a scale through the state, if there would be a co-payment for services. We start everyone off on our basic program, so it's about a few hours or so a week of either homemaking, personal,
yeah,
care. The meals can be included in that at no cost. We do provide a personal emergency response button we can as part of the program.
Which is like what we know as Lifeline.
Lifeline,
right.
Yes.
That can be part of it.
Yep.
And by the way, just as you were going through, you know, what is considered a critical need, I know, like, in my MassHealth world,
yep,
right, to qualify for a lot of those programs, mm-hmm, you got to really need, you know, you need to be needing personal assistance to,
right,
do something like bathing and stuff.
And
that's, but what you're talking about is a much lower standard. You may,
right,
need, you know, what you, as you had mentioned, shopping, you,
yes,
kind of,
the homemaking.
Homemaking
services can do an array of different things, from,
yeah,
shopping to help with laundry, bed making, like anything from light cleaning. So that's our homemaker service, and we do contract out with different vendors on the island for the services. It's actually not Elder Services of Cape Cod and the Islands that provides the service. We,
right,
contract out with the Visiting Nurses Association of Cape Cod and Greater Boston Home Health Services. And we also can use Best of Care Agency as well. That's kind of our, Best of Care is our backup to Greater Boston and VNA. But that's actually how the in-home services are being provided, is through those vendors.
I see. So you're just figuring out the package. You're kind of like the public side of Sandy in some ways. You're kind,
yes,
of figuring out the package and then kind of seeing if the players can fall into place.
Exactly. Yes.
And Megan lets,
yep,
me, so we can help too, you, mm-hmm, know, with my clients, but you do,
exactly,
this for like everybody. But if you're just struggling a little bit because your laundry's in the basement and you,
right,
can't go up and down the stairs anymore,
yep,
or at least
that's
not with a big laundry basket.
That's a great example.
Right.
Or if making your bed is, you know, you've got some arthritis,
mm-hmm,
or whatever, making your bed, or you're a little short of breath sometimes, if you've got a bit of, you know, respiratory issues,
mm-hmm,
or if standing at the stove making your meals is,
right,
is, you know, too painful for,
exactly,
you.
Mm-hmm.
So you don't have to be, I like to think of Elder Services as the first level of care need,
mm-hmm,
before you need a lot more stuff. Sometimes,
mm-hmm,
you just need that first basic home care,
right, exactly,
to help things, you know,
mm-hmm,
get some meals in the house,
exactly,
that are easier so that you're not spending your energy making your meals,
mm-hmm,
and getting some help with the laundry, and maybe you're not able to drive anymore.
Right.
That shopping is enormous. How are you going to get groceries without Elder,
exactly,
Services?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I would think the shopping would be enormous.
It's,
yes,
a wonderful program.
And now you said there's a copay. But once again, this isn't one of those where there's an asset, there's no asset requirement. It's based on your income, there's a copay.
Basic income.
Can you give people a sense of how much the copay might be?
It really depends on the income, because it's a sliding scale, like I said, anywhere from $10 to $141 a month, depending on their yearly income.
Right.
And MassHealth does come into play actually with our services as well. So if you have MassHealth insurance, most of the MassHealth insurances, you will not have a copayment for services.
Nice. Oh, no, I didn't even realize. I didn't even know that.
So the only insurance that through MassHealth that would have is Health Safety Net. But all the other ones we do take and would be no copayment for services.
I see. And once again, people talk, you know, I always try to push those and say, you know, you talk about there's a copayment, but when you calculate what those services or those home care services would cost hourly compared to what the copay is, it's like insignificant.
Right.
Insignificant.
Right. Yes.
So that's all one. That's all wonderful. Yeah. So there's home care, and there's that package of things that go with it, right? And is there a name for that package? Is that just the basic package?
We call it the home care basic program. That's what everyone starts off on. Mm-hmm. There is a range of income to qualify for the home care basic program, and that would be a set copayment. But if they're what's over income, they would actually be a percentage copayment. So it goes from 50% to 100% in 5% increments. Depending on their income if they are over. That program is actually a little more limited to the amount of service we can offer. It's about 3 hours or so a week, and it's a percentage copayment, like I said. So we can still offer the services to people who are over income. And before, it used to be that they would have to have a caregiver in place for what's called respite. Yeah. It used to be called our respite over income program. Now they do not have to have a caregiver, so anyone can open up for services if they're over income. They don't have to have a caregiver. So.
And by the way, I think
that's
kind of one
awesome.
Of one,
yeah, yeah, I didn't know that part.
But one of the morals of this story is, don't try to remember everything you're hearing now.
No. Right.
The goal, call her.
Yes,
right.
Definitely. I guess call me.
Right.
Absolutely.
That's
give
the goal.
Me a call that, anytime.
Right.
I'm
right,
happy to discuss all the programs.
That stuff out.
Or that phone number, 800-244-4630.
Yes, that's our main referral number. So if you want any information on the programs, you can give the INR specialist a call. It's our information and referral program. That's where all of our referrals for any of our programs have to come through first. And then what they do is they distribute it to the area. So Cape Cod and the islands. If it was someone on the Cape, it would go to our South Dennis office, which is our main office. If it was someone on the Vineyard or Nantucket, we do have an office in Nantucket as well as Martha's Vineyard, so it'll go to those respective offices.
We're supposed to just call that the other island. We don't
call it the other island. You said the Nantucket word.
Now, you said there's also a specialty package in addition to basic.
There is.
Can we just talk about that a little bit?
So you do have to be clinically eligible through our nurse. So that's where our nurse's role comes into play. She goes out.
Oh, you have a full-time nurse. In addition to the case managers, you have a full-time nurse?
As part of our home care program, we have a part-time nurse. Yeah. Her name is Diane.
Yeah.
And she goes out to see you and clinically qualify you for the next level of services. And she also does what's called a personal care plan for anyone who needs personal care services. So that's any services more hands-on to help with showering, bathing, dressing, all of those services. She would help develop a personal care plan that we then send into our vendors so that they can get more of a specialized care plan for that. And for our specialty programs, we have what's called our Enhanced Community Options Program. That does allow someone to get more help weekly for services.
We call it ECOP. Slowly but surely.
Enhanced Community Options, So our nurse would have to go out to approve them. She does a clinical eligibility screening to approve them for the next level. And that's anywhere from 9 to 10 hours or so a week, depending on what they need. And we put personal care, homemaking, all of those different services in for them.
And again, you don't have to be sort of in a wheelchair and unable to walk. It needs to be considered unsafe for you to shower without some level of supervision.
Yeah.
And what I tell my clients all the time is it doesn't matter that you are doing it now. What matters is, are you safe to do it?
Mm-hmm.
Should you have someone with you while you're showering just to make sure? I mean, there's nothing soft you're going to hit if you fall in the shower.
Yeah, exactly.
So that is such a wonderful program. There's other things that people wouldn't think about that can be included, like the Lifeline we talked about.
Mm-hmm.
That's a wonderful part of it.
Right. Yep.
And also, there's a great laundry service.
There is.
A laundry service.
A laundry service.
offer through Airport Laundry. That's our vendor that we contract with. They pick up the laundry once a week and bring it back the next day folded. So it's a great
Seriously,
service.
I can't wait till I'm 60.
I've never heard of this. I've never heard of, because I deal with the ACE, the Aging Services Access Points, likes Elder Services in our own area. I've never heard of that one.
Yeah.
That's great.
Yeah, it's a great service. A lot of people really like that one.
It's just one of those things that you say, do I need to be doing this?
Especially, most
of the old houses, you know, if the washer dryer is down the cellar,
right?
Where that's where you're gonna. I mean, I've lost a lot of clients going downstairs to the cellar.
And we'd really like to prevent falls, and that's a huge thing
that's risk?
Being looked at in the community.
Well, even
right
if you
now,
can you do it with a basket of laundry?
Mm-hmm. Right.
And one of the things that I find too is some of my elders, their washing machine seems to be aging in place with them. So if
it
would
buy a new washing machine,
right?
You know, you're 75. Come on.
So sometimes it's just about giving the machines a bit of a break and having the program through Elder Services help out with some of the laundry, because you know if the personal plumbing's not working so good and you're doing a lot of laundry, sometimes it can help to have a few loads done, and it is seriously magical, Megan.
Right.
It goes out on the doorstep, like say on a Thursday morning, and it comes back washed, smelling great, and folded for you the next day, and you just have to put it away. It's an amazing service.
Just to clarify too, that's one of the services that's offered through our home care program. So you would have to qualify for the clinical eligibility part in order to get that laundry, but it can be included as part of one of the services as well.
Sure.
I was just gonna mention, what's the theme here is that it's those little things that are magic. It doesn't take a lot for a lot of these folks to be able to stay at home.
Right.
You know, it's just this accumulation of little things that start getting worse that really reduce the quality of your life at home. But something like just not having to think about the laundry is just such a huge.
Or having somebody just go get the mail and do the shopping.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Some just
bring me my mail and go and do the shopping and get the trash out of the house. And that's where so many falls happen, is people trying to just do the little homemaking things. Mm-hmm.
That also deals with the issue of the car. You know, you're feeling I really don't want to be driving that much anymore. And as I tell my clients, you're getting older, you got a little neuropathy. I remember talking to this lady who finally gave up her license. She was 94. I said, Margie, you're gonna feel terrible. You're gonna be driving. You're gonna hit a little kid because you couldn't get your foot to the brake, and you're never gonna forgive yourself. It isn't about you. It's about the others. But it was the shopping.
I know.
It was how am I going to get out otherwise? You know, so it's very straight. It's like the little stuff, you know.
And I think the important thing that you were saying too before we sat down here and to just remind our viewers is there is those programs, which are sort of the springboard, the Meals on Wheels, the basic, and then the extended community options program. Yeah. But then there's other things like medication management and financial management.
Right.
There is this gigantic menu of services that you can get from Megan and her group. And it's about making that first phone call into 800-244-4630. And just talk to them. Because they make my life easier.
I know Sandy's number by heart.
We've got each other's number, as we said. Yeah. So I think it's just about calling and having a conversation with that person in the intake and referral center and tell them your story. And they'll get somebody to come out to the house and sit down and have a conversation with you about what they can do.
And help you figure it out.
Yeah.
Now, the other thing that I just want to mention is the unique relationship you have with the day program, with the Center for Living, right? Mm-hmm. As I had mentioned to you, this is the only place I know of in the Commonwealth of Massachusetts, and I do a lot of this stuff around, right, where if you are on MassHealth, right, you can Elder Services will pay for the cost of going to the day program, right?
Yes, it's included as part of our home care program, and actually you don't have to be on MassHealth.
You just have
to qualify for the home care program, and then we can offer the supportive day.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. The laundry,
I didn't know that either.
Yeah.
I didn't know that either.
Yep.
And once again, the home care program, and that's the one for which there's some clinical eligibility?
No. The home care program is the critical need has to be there first to open. Then we start everyone off on the home care basic program, and then we can look at options to move them up. We have the ECOP program, which we talked about, and we also do have the Choices program, which is a frail elder waiver program in MassHealth Standard. And that actually offers even more services than the Enhanced Community Options program. You do have to qualify for MassHealth Standard, and it's another program that you do have to be clinically eligible for the frail elder waiver.
Right. And that's a higher to qualify for MassHealth Standard. Now you're talking about having some asset limitations, so you need to be doing some other stuff. But as I always tell folks, you know, for that program, if you're single, this can be a problem. If you're married, talk to somebody, because you can usually rearrange your assets so that the healthier, and by transferring things to the healthier spouse and having that healthier spouse rearrange their assets, just like if you're going to a nursing home, so you can get those programs. Because you know, ultimately, while Windermere is fine, I don't have a single person that's just dying to go to Windermere, right? But to stay home, to be able to, and can you give folks a sense, you know, once you've gone through those hoops and qualified for that program, about how many hours of care that might be provided through, you know, once again through elder services, right, but really as a MassHealth benefit.
So through the MassHealth Choices program, we say 42 hours a week of in-home services, and even more if it's a hands-on task-oriented thing. So we can do even over 42 if they qualify for that. And it's, you know, the array of different services we can put in as part of that. It does come down a little bit to worker availability. That I know that's come up a lot in the community. So if we
that
have it available.
That comes up a lot.
Yes.
Every show.
Like every show.
Exactly. Right. So if we have it available on the Choices program, we can put in up to 42 hours and over if it's a task-oriented thing. So.
And as we deal with all the time, 42 hours, so it's not a complete week, you know, there's more, but it's a lot.
Right.
So if you're taking care of somebody, but you know, you need breaks, or if you're a younger person, you've got a job, you can make that program work, right?
Yes.
And if you need more, and if you need more hours than that, you know, oftentimes you can restructure your assets so that you've got your program, and then there are some other hours that can supplement.
And that's the great thing about this island, too, is there's so many different organizations geared towards helping with specific areas. And it's great to just know about them. Like, we work with Vineyard Healthcare Access all the time for people who are looking to get on MassHealth insurance and looking to see what they have to do to qualify.
Right.
We refer to them. So it's good to have all those community players and all those connections like Sandy and everyone.
Sarah Koo and Mary Letty.
Exactly, to reach out to.
They are angels.
But,
yes.
But once again, what you're saying is, all roads should start with her.
Oh, definitely.
All roads.
Megan will filter it all out for you and get you and her crew, you know, lead you into the right direction.
Exactly.
It's an incredible
Anything
program.
With Elder Services of Cape Cod and the Islands, any questions, you can always feel free to call me. We do say it's great to reach out to the senior centers and the COAs for all of the resources as well. They're a great starting point and connection too, and they know, you know, about us and all the different organizations
and
can connect you with them as well.
Whoever you're comfortable with, just, make a phone call.
Yeah.
And now everybody knows her.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So they can actually call. Well, this was a wonderful idea.
Thank you. I am so proud of Megan. I mean, what you've done and what you're doing for this community, I get all, you know, sort of emotional about it, but what an amazing job you've done to help so many people on this island.
And she's so young. We're both going to be dead. She's still going to be doing
this. Yeah, she's going to be taking care of. She's going to be ordering home care for us someday.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Well, if I can ever get to move here. So listen, thank you very, very much.
Thank you
for having
me. We
really, really appreciate your coming, Sandy. This is a great idea.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you. Thank you for watching. Once again, you've got Megan's number, right? You can call her, right? Even if you think you're calling Dennis, you're really ultimately going to be calling her. Thank you very much for watching. Give Megan a call if you've got any problems, and I will look forward to seeing you in the next installment of Frank and Mary on Martha's Vineyard. Thank you. Thank you.